Hi everyone, this is the video number 8 of the chapter number 4, 12th physics. Okay. In video number 7, we have seen the magnetic force on a moving charge with velocity v, and that was q v cross b. Okay, magnetic force F is given by Q V cross B. Today we will see ahead in this magnetic force. Today we will see magnetic force on current carrying conductor. Okay, magnetic force on current carrying conductor. So suppose we are having one wire conductor wire. Suppose it has length L, it has this cross section area A, and from this wire I current is flowing. Okay, this is one conductor wire, its length is L, its cross section area is A, and from it current I is flowing. So due to this current flowing, what will be magnetic force on it, that we will find. And suppose it is in magnetic field, suppose it is in uniform magnetic field like this. Okay, this cross is showing the uniform magnetic field inside. So this is one wire, current I is flowing from it, and it is placed in uniform magnetic field B. So on this wire there will be some magnetic force, and we will derive the formula of that magnetic force on current carrying conductor. Okay, general formula to prove the magnetic force, we will use this general formula, that is the Q V cross B. So first we will find out Q, charge of this wire. So to find the charge of this wire, first we will take that the number density of charge of this wire. For charge we will take electron. Okay, in current electron is flowing. So number density of charge or electron of wire is suppose small f. Number density means what is number density? What do you mean by number density? Number density means the number of electrons or charge per unit volume. Okay, this means number density is number of charge per unit volume or number of electrons per unit volume. So what is the, if number density is small n, then what is the total number of electrons in this wire? See, in unit volume, how many number of electrons are there? Small n. Here we are having the volume of the wire, that is the area into length, A into L. So total number of electrons, suppose we are telling it capital N, it will be small n into V, that is the capital V, volume. Okay, this V is showing the volume of the wire. So total number of electrons, number density into volume. Number density n and volume is AL. So these are the total number of electrons in this wire. So what is the total charge of this wire? Total charge, you know, according to quantization, Q is equals to NE. So here total charge is NALE. This is the total charge Q. Okay. So now we will find out the magnetic force on this current carrying wire. That F is equals to Q V cross B. Here actually Q is charge, that is the NALE. In conductor the velocity of electron is written by VD and cross B. B is magnetic field. Here see, velocity of electron is in the direction of current, that will be in this direction, and magnetic field is inward. So what is the direction between velocity of electron and magnetic field? That is the perpendicular 90 degree. Okay, so here we can say that force F is equals to NALE VD B sin theta, but theta is 90, sin 90 is 1. So magnetic force F is written as NALE VD B. This is the magnetic force acting on this wire. Okay, now we will simplify this formula. To simplify this, see, in chapter number 3 there is one formula. If you have not completed or studied the chapter number 3, then just use this formula or remember this formula. The formula of current in wire, I is given as NEAVD. Okay, current is given as I is equals to NEAVD. Now put this I in the above formula magnetic force. Then magnetic force F is equals to, see here we have got this formula. We have got the formula, that is the NALEVDB. In this NAEVD, instead of this NAEVD, we will put the current I. Okay, so F is equals to ILB. So this is the formula of the magnetic force on the current carrying wire. But in this case, the current I and magnetic field, or the length L, okay, IL, that is the current carrying element, and magnetic field B is perpendicular to each other. Here there is the case theta is equals to 90 degree. But in universal case, we will write this as IL cross B. Okay, हमने थीटा 90 डिग्री एंगल लिया था हमारी थियरी में, तो अगर 90 डिग्री एंगल नहीं हो तो ये यूनिवर्सल फॉर्मूला मैग्नेटिक फोर्स की करंट कैरिंग लूप में F इज इक्वल्स टू आई एल क्रॉस बी. ओके, सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स ऑन करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर. ओके, इफ वी आर गिवन स्मॉल एलिमेंट्स ऑफ करंट, इफ वी आर गिवन स्मॉल एलिमेंट्स ऑफ करंट and if we want to find out the total magnetic force, then what we will do? We will integrate this formula IL cross B. Okay, or we will add this all the small forces. Okay, so if small current elements are given, then total magnetic force F is the summation of the IDL cross B. Okay, this DL is the for small element. If whole element is given, then this is the proper formula IL cross B. If small elements are given, then we will integrate or add the total force IDL cross B. So this is the magnetic force on current carrying element. Now we will do the numerical based on this theory. First is illustration number 1. Okay, 2 marks ke liye IMP example. In this illustration, we are given that there is a wire which is of mass 200 gram. This wire has mass is equals to 200 gram. And its length is 1.5 meter. This wire is of length 1.5 meter. From this wire, some current is flowing, that is the 2 ampere. Okay, and it is hanging in air. It is raised in air in the horizontal magnetic field. So suppose this is the current I in this direction, then there will be magnetic field in this direction. Okay, and due to this magnetic field, on this current carrying wire, there will be some magnetic force. Okay, and due to this, that magnetic force, दिस करंट कैरिंग वायर इज फ्री इन एयर, ओके, इज हैंगिंग फ्री इन एयर एंड वी आर आस्क्ड टू फाइंड आउट दिस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। देखो मैं आपको टोटल केस समझाता हूं, ये एक वायर जो कि हवा में लटक रहा है, ये मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में, ओके, वो वायर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में तो है ही और हवा में लटक रहा है। अब कोई भी चीज को अगर हम हवा में रख दें तो उस पर एक फोर्स तो लगेगा, दैट इज द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स, ओके। एंड हियर ये वायर हवा में लटक रहा है, इट इज फ्री हैंगिंग इन द एयर, सो दैट दिस मच ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज एक्टिंग इन अपर डायरेक्शन ऑल्सो एंड दैट विल बी कंपल्सरी मैग्नेटिक फोर्स। एंड सी हियर मैग्नेटिक फोर्स विल बी इन अपर डायरेक्शन, हाउ, करंट आई इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन, सो परपेंडिकुलर टू बोथ मैग्नेटिक फोर्स विल बी देयर, ओके, सो मैग्नेटिक फोर्स विल बी इन दिस अपर डायरेक्शन, आई इज इन एक्स डायरेक्शन, बी इज इन जेड डायरेक्शन, सो मैग्नेटिक फोर्स विल बी इन वाई डायरेक्शन, सिंपल। सो देयर इज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड वी आर आस्क्ड टू फाइंड आउट दिस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, ओके, सो वी कैन से दैट ऑन वायर ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज इक्वल्स टू मैग्नेटिक फोर्स, ग्रेविटेशन फोर्स इज एम जी एंड मैग्नेटिक फोर्स इज आई एल बी, मेक द सब्जेक्ट बी दैट इज द एम जी अपॉन आई एल, पुट ऑल द वैल्यू, एम इज 200 ग्राम सो 0.2 इन के जी, जी इज 9.8, करंट आई इज 2 एंड लेंथ इज 1.5, सो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इफ यू विल कैलकुलेट देन यू कैन फाइंड द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी दैट इज द 0.65 टेस्ला, ओके, दिस इज द आंसर। अब इफ यू आर कंफ्यूजिंग इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फोर्स देन रिमेंबर वी कैन फाइंड आउट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फोर्स बाय द फ्लेमिंग्स राइट हैंड रूल और बाय सिंपली यू कैन रिमेंबर दैट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फोर्स, द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फोर्स विल बी परपेंडिकुलर टू बोथ करंट एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, ओके, सेम वे दैट वॉज द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स वॉज परपेंडिकुलर टू वेलोसिटी ऑफ चार्ज एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, सेम एज हियर मैग्नेटिक फोर्स डायरेक्शन इज परपेंडिकुलर टू करंट आई एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बोथ, ओके, सो हियर करंट आई इज इन एक्स डायरेक्शन, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी इन जेड डायरेक्शन, सो ऑब्वियसली मैग्नेटिक फोर्स विल बी इन वाई डायरेक्शन एंड फॉर दैट मैग्नेटिक फोर्स, ड्यू टू दैट मैग्नेटिक फोर्स दिस वायर इज हैंगिंग इन एयर, सो दिस इज द इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर वन। नाउ वी विल सी एक्सरसाइज न्यूमेरिकल, फर्स्ट वी विल सी एक्सरसाइज फिफ्थ, एक्सरसाइज फिफ्थ न्यूमेरिकल इज वेरी इजी, इन इट वी आर गिवन दैट देर इज मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ऑफ 0.15 टेस्ला, इट इज एंड देर इज ए वायर ऑल्सो फ्रॉम विच 8 एम्पियर करंट इज फ्लोइंग एंड दिस वायर इज एट द 30 डिग्री एंगल विथ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, ओके, सो सपोज दिस इज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड देन वायर इज नॉट स्ट्रेट, इट इज लाइक दिस एंड मेकिंग द एंगल 30 डिग्री विद द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड वी आर आस्क्ड टू फाइंड आउट द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स ऑन दैट वायर, सो वॉट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ दैट मैग्नेटिक फोर्स, आई एल बी साइन थीटा और आई एल क्रॉस बी, ओके, आई एल क्रॉस बी मीन्स आई एल बी साइन थीटा, पुट द वैल्यू आई दैट इज द 8 एम्पियर, एल लेंथ इज नॉट गिवन सो वी विल टेक एज 1 मीटर, B that is the magnetic field 0.15, sin theta that means sin 30, okay, so 8 into 0.15 into sin 30 means 1/2, so again you can calculate this in your calculator and you can find out the answer of magnetic force in Tesla, okay, in which direction this magnetic force will be there, so perpendicular to magnetic field, perpendicular to magnetic field and current, perpendicular to both magnetic field and current, magnetic force will be there, okay, so somewhere in this direction. there will be magnetic force. Okay, this is the wire. In this direction there will be magnetic field, inward direction. So in this direction, perpendicular to both, there will be magnetic force. Okay, so this is the exercise number 5th. Now we will do last numerical based on this theory, that is the exercise number 6th. So exercise number 6th numerical, in this numerical we are given that there is a wire of length 3 cm, that means 3 × 10⁻²⁻² meter, in which current 10 ampere is flowing, and this wire is placed in one solenoid perpendicular to its axis. Okay, and in the solenoid magnetic field is given 0.27 tesla. So we are asked to find out the magnetic force on this wire. So actually this is the case in which there is one solenoid. Suppose this is one solenoid. Okay, in this solenoid, these are the wounding wires, it is not important to us. In this solenoid there is the magnetic field that is given directly to us, that is the 0.27 tesla, and wire of this 3 cm length is placed perpendicular to the axis. This is the axis of solenoid, so wire is placed like this. This is the wire. Okay, this is the wire placed perpendicular to the solenoid. So in this direction there is the current I flowing, upward direction. If this is the solenoid and this is the axis of solenoid, then magnetic field will be in this direction. Okay, you can understand that in solenoid theory we have stated that if this is solenoid, then magnetic field will be always parallel to its axis. So it will be in this direction or reverse. Suppose this current I is flowing in this direction, and we are asked to find out the magnetic force. Again, there is simple only formula. Place the formula and find out the answer. Magnetic force Fm is equals to, formula is ILB. Current I is 10 ampere, length is 3 × 10⁻¹². Okay, sorry, −2, and B is 0.27. So you can find the answer, that is the 8.1 × 10⁻²⁻² newton. Yes, 8.1 × 10⁻²⁻² newton. At direction, you can also find the direction. Why we have placed the only ILB? Because here we are given sine theta and theta is 90. See, B is in this direction, I is in this direction. So there is angle 90 degree, and if angle is 90 degree, then it will be sine 91. Okay, now direction, for direction, again put this formula, F is equals to IL cross B. We are finding the direction by numerically. IL means direction of current, that is the in Y direction. So J cross, J cap cross B, that is the in X direction. So I cap. What is the answer of J cross I? Okay, that is the minus K cap. So magnetic force will be in negative z axis direction, means inward. Okay, outward means positive, inward means negative. So in this figure we can say that on this wire there will be force, but in inward direction, and it will be magnitude of 8.1 × 10⁻²⁻² newton. Okay, so this is the magnetic force on current carrying element. Okay, thank you.